Hi there. This is Lawrence Simon, a technical writer on the documentation team at cPanel, the hosting platform of choice. It's all about the cloud these days. Did you know that you can create a cPanel and WHM server instance in the cloud? In this video, I'll demonstrate how to launch a cPanel and WHM server on a Google Compute Engine instance. We'll perform the following tasks. We'll log into Google. We'll configure the instance and launch it. We'll set the root password and the hostname at the command line. We'll configure a static IP address. And then we'll connect to WHM. The first step is to navigate to the Google Compute Engine's website, cloud.google.com. Click Get Started for Free. Then, log in to Google with your email address and password. If you don't already have an account at Google, you'll need to sign up for one. After you get that taken care of, or if you've already got an account at Google, select the checkbox to accept the terms of service. Then, click Continue. The Payment Information interface will appear. Enter your payment information or confirm the payment information already on your account. I'd prefer not to include my billing information in this video, so I'll skip ahead to the next part, okay? The Google Cloud Platform interface will appear, and Google will send you a confirmation email. Now, we'll search for the marketplace listing for cPanel and WHM. In the left navigation bar, click Marketplace. The Marketplace window will appear. Search for cPanel. A list of products will appear. Click cPanel and WHM on Linux. The cPanel and WHM Marketplace profile will appear. Read the details on this page. It will contain links to our documentation and other helpful resources. When you're done reading the page, click Launch on Compute Engine. You must enable billing on your account to proceed. Click Enable Billing. Wait for the Configuring APIs message to vanish. It'll take a few minutes. Okay, we're now ready to create our instance. In the Deployment Name text box, enter a name for the instance. The deployment name can only contain lowercase letters, numbers, or dashes, and it must start with a lowercase letter and cannot end with a dash. This step will not set the hostname of the server. It's just a label for the Google dashboard. We'll set the hostname later. The Zone menu allows you to select the data center in which to create the server. Google's regional data centers are located around the world, so select one that's either near your location or near your customers. The minimum requirements of cPanel and WHM on Google Compute Engine are slightly different than our normal minimum requirements. You'll need at least 1 GB of RAM and 40 GB of disk space, but we recommend at least 2 GB of RAM and 40 GB of disk space. Then, select the number of CPUs you'll need. Click Customize if your instance requires more memory, a specific CPU style, or to specify the number of CPUs. Let's return to the basic view. In the Boot Disk section, select Standard Persistent Disk for the boot disk type. And then, set the boot disk size in gigabytes text box to a value of 40 GB or more. In the networking section, do not make any changes. And then, in the firewall section, we've pre-configured the ports you'll need for basic cPanel and WHM services. However, if you know of additional ports you'll need to open due to software that you plan to run, you can add those firewall rules here. or you can change them through the Google Cloud dashboard after installation. These settings control the firewall at Google, not the firewall that will be built into your system. Click Deploy. The Deployment Manager interface will appear. When the instance is ready, you'll see a green icon next to the instance name. The right panel will contain helpful information to get you logged into your server. Let's go ahead and log in. Click SSH. A new window will appear with a terminal session. Then, enter sudo space su space dash to get root access. Run the passwd command. Then, enter a new password. And finally, enter that new password again. A confirmation message will appear. To assign a hostname to the server, enter the following command. Hostname CTL space set-hostname, and then your desired hostname. To configure VPS deployments, many cloud hosting providers use the dhclient command. This command includes the configuration of the instance's hostname, but the dhclient command may not preserve the locally configured hostname. So, hosting providers use scripts to work around this issue. For example, Google Cloud Platform Services uses the Google Set Hostname script. Be sure to change the hostname to the hostname that you plan to use for your server. I'll put a link to the documentation with the command, and I'll also put it in the comments of this video. And I'm pasting in an example of that script for this particular hostname. Okay, let's close the terminal session. By default, Google assigns ephemeral IP addresses to instances. If you restart your server, Google may assign a different IP address to it. We need to configure a static IP address. To do that, let's go to the External IP Addresses page. Click Learn More. A help page will appear. Click Go to the External IP Addresses page. The External IP Addresses page will appear. Then, click the arrow next to Ephemeral. A new window will appear. In the Name text box, enter a name for the IP address. In the Description text box, enter a description for it. And finally, click Reserve. A success message will appear. Let's return to the deployment interface and click the Admin URL link. Your browser may display a few security warnings. Your server starts with a self-signed certificate. Later on, you can set up a hostname certificate to secure your server and get rid of those warnings. A login interface will appear. Then, enter the root username and the password that you just set. And click Login. A new interface will appear that asks you to agree to our software license. Go ahead and read it. And then click Agree to All. Another interface will appear that will ask you for your contact information and the name servers for your server to use. I'll enter my email address as the contact. As for the primary name server, enter ns1 dot and the domain name that you plan to use for the server. I'm using cpaneldemonstration.com. Then for the second name server, use ns2 dot and that domain name. Then click Finish. The WHM interface will appear. every cPanel and WHM server that's new on a particular IP address comes with a 15-day trial license. You can contact cPanel if you wish to buy a license, or you can buy one directly from within the WHM interface. If you see a warning about a new version of cPanel and WHM available, don't worry about that. As part of the installation process, cPanel and WHM is updating itself as a background task. However, if you see a warning about requiring a reboot to apply software updates, that means that there is a new operating system kernel available. You can take care of that reboot after you get things set up on your server. One other important note. By default, Google blocks port 25. cPanel and WHM uses port 25 to send email. So it's important to configure a relay for your server if you plan to send email from it. I'll put a link in the show notes for some helpful resources to get you set up for a relay and configuring your server. For more information about cPanel, the hosting platform of choice, visit cPanel.com or follow us on Twitter at cPanel. What did you think of this video? Let us know in the comments. And for more helpful videos, subscribe to our cPanel channel. Thank you for watching, and enjoy.